Okay, so we have to discuss the combination of capacitors. First of all, as you have studied in class 10th, there are different combinations in which your resistances can be used. Similarly, there are combinations in which capacitance can also be used, and those combinations are again series and parallel combinations. So we'll be starting with that today. So the first combination which we are going to study is capacitors in series. You have studied about your resistances in series. In that case, you use resistances in this way. If there are different resistances R1 R2 and R3, if they are connected like this, we will say they are in series. They are connected in series. When all the resistances are connected to the same terminals of a cell. And when the resistances were connected like this, we call them to be in parallel. Now they are in parallel. Similarly, beta, we will study about the capacitors. When we know the symbol of capacitor, for fixed capacitance, the symbol is this. So when the capacitances are connected like this, then they are in series. When they are connected like this, they'll be in parallel. Let me show you. We will start with series. So let us say there are three capacitors having capacitances C1, C2 and C3. And they are connected to one common battery or cell. And we are saying that this battery is providing a potential difference of V volt. Okay. Now you can see there are different capacitances which are connected like this. So they will be called capacitances in series. Right? Why series? Because the positive terminal of battery is connected to, first of all, the one plate of capacitor. Then the second plate of capacitor is connected to the other plate of capacitor, second capacitor, like this. And the final plate of the third capacitor is connected to the second terminal, yani ke negative terminal of our battery. So this is a series combination. Now we want to find out the formula for this series combination. So you know that for a series combination, we have different potentials across different resistances. This you have already studied, that if there are resistances in series, then there are certain characteristics of a series combination. The first one is there will be different potential drop across different resistors, and the charge or current will remain same. In this case, we will talk about charge. So charge will remain same. So let us see how the charge will remain same. We can see the we know that the charge is same. So we will say that across all the capacitors, let us say Q charge is present on the plates of the capacitors, right? So we have fixed some things now. The potential is fixed, which is V provided to the plates of the capacitors. Then we have different capacitances of capacitors. See, first capacitor is having capacitance C1, second capacitor is having capacitance C2, and third capacitor is having capacitance C3. Now we know that C is equal to Q by V. Now when Q is constant but C is different, that means in this case V will be different across the first capacitor. Why? Because Q is same, but C, the capacitance is different. So by this formula, we will get a different potential drop across the first capacitor. Let us say that potential is V1. Similarly, in the second capacitor, capacitance is C2, charge is same. So again, there will be different potential drop, that let us say that is V2. And in third case also, C3, the capacitance is different. Because of this different capacitance, our potential drop will be different across this. So it let it be V3. Now we have given the same potential to all the capacitors. We have given potential V, but when we are talking about different capacitances individually, then across first capacitor, our potential difference is V1. Because the capacitance is different. Then for second capacitor, the potential difference is V2, and across third potential difference is V3. But we know that the total potential of the circuit should remain same, and that should be the sum of all the potentials. From this formula, the above formula, we get value of V1. So V1 is equal to Q upon C1. V2 is equal to Q upon C2. And V3 is equal to Q upon C3. So we can put that value here. So by putting that value, we get V1 will be equal to Q upon C1. V2 is equal to Q upon C2. And V3 is equal to Q upon C3, right? But for whole circuit, if we are talking about whole circuit, let us say the capacitance of the circuit is Cs. So from here we will get Cs is equal to Q upon V, because for whole circuit the potential is V, your charge is same, that is Q. So we can say V is equal to Q upon Cs, right? So from here,
Q common.
Yes. Just a second. From here, we will put the value of V also. So we get Q upon Cs is equal to Q upon C1 plus Q upon C2 plus Q upon C3. So from here, Q is common, so Q will be cancelled out from both the sides. We are left with 1 upon Cs is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3. So when we combine the capacitances in series combination, then we use this formula. It is very much different from the formula which we use for resistors. For resistors, the formula is R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, right? So it is very different from the formula of resistances when they are in series. So you will keep this formula in your mind. So we got the formula that 1 upon Cs is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3 when three capacitors were there of different capacitances. Is baat ko yaad rakhna hai, different capacitance hai, isliye aisa ho raha hai. Okay, but if we want to generalize it. So we say if there are n capacitors, if there are n capacitors of different capacitances, then we can generalize the formula. So it will become 1 upon Cs is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3 up to Cn. So this will be the generalized formula for the capacitance in series. So there are certain characteristics of this. Let us understand those characteristics. So the first one says, we have done all this. We have taken why V1 is there, because the capacitance is different, so potential drop across this, these two plates will be different. So it will be V1 for second, it will be V2 for third, it will be excuse me, V3. Charge is same, because in capacitance the current flows is the current in the circuit is same for series combination. Or here also we can see the charge is same, that means the current, the charge across which is transferring from one plate to another, will remain same for all the capacitances. Now if we talk about the characteristics, so first of all, the reciprocal of equivalent capacitance is equal to the sum of the reciprocals of the individual capacitances. Second one, the equivalent capacitance Cs is smaller than the smallest individual capacitance. This is very important. The equivalent capacitance is smaller than the smallest individual capacitance for series combination. Now the charge on each capacitor is same. Har ek capacitor par jo charge hai wo same rahega. The charge on each capacitor is same. Fourth one, the potential difference across any capacitor is inversely proportional to its capacitance. You can see from here, C is inversely proportional to V. So potential difference across any capacitor, if we are talking about individual capacitors, then the potential difference across that capacitor will be inversely proportional to its capacitance. So this means that if capacitance is large, that means potential difference across the plates will be less, and if potential difference is more, then the capacitance will be less. Now we come on to the second topic, that is capacitors in parallel. How do you differentiate the series and parallel combination? It is very important. So you have to see if the terminals of the battery are connected to one plate of first capacitor and the second plate of last capacitor. That means they are in series. And if the capacitors, each capacitor's plates, that is the one plate of each capacitor is connected to one common terminal, and second plate of each capacitor is connected to the next common terminal of the potential or the battery, that means this is a parallel combination. For parallel combination, all the plates of the capacitors will be connected to one terminal of the battery, and all the second plates of the capacitors will be connected to the other terminal of the battery. This you have to recognize in numericals also. How will you recognize? I have told you. Now when the positive plates of all the capacitors are connected to one point and the negative plates to another common point, the capacitors are said to be connected in parallel. Now again, let us consider three capacitors of different capacitances. So it is a capacitor 1 is having capacitance C1, capacitor 2 is having capacitance C2, then capacitor 3 is having capacitance C3. We have connected them with a battery of potential difference V. Now because they are in parallel combination, so potential difference across all the points will be same, because all the plates are connected to the both the terminals of the battery, so there will be no different potential drop. All the plates will be on the same potential difference, that is V. Now because their potential difference is same but capacitances are different, so the charge on all the plates will be different. So let us again understand it. So now we are talking about the capacitance in parallel. Now, as I have told you, they are on the same, they are having same potential difference across them because they are in parallel. So the charge, if we talk about the charge in first capacitor, so it will be Q1 is equal to C1V. Why? Because now V is constant but C is different. So by the formula C is equal to Q by V, we get Q is equal to C into V. But here because C is different, so it is C1. So charge will be also different on the first capacitor. Now for second capacitor, the charge will become C2V. And for the third capacitor, the charge will become C3V. And if we talk about the charge on whole system, then the total charge on the system by superposition principle, it will be, let us say it is Q. So Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Now from here, you can put the value of these charges Q1, Q2, Q3 from the above equations. So it becomes Q is equal to C1V plus C2V plus C3V. And we know that the total charge on the system is Q. So Q is equal to C into V, where let us say Cp into V, where Cp is the capacitance of the equivalent capacitance of the circuit. So Cp is the capacitance of the circuit, whole circuit. So we can put this value here. Q, for Q we can put Cpv, and other values are C1V plus C2V plus C3V. Now from here again we can take one point, one thing common, that is V. So if we take V common from both the sides, we will can be cancelled out. So we are left with Cp is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. So from here we get the formula for the parallel combination of capacitances. Now it is different from the formula for the series. When series are kept in parallel, your resistances are kept in parallel, then the formula is this. So it is very different from the formula of the capacitances in parallel. Right now we are focusing on this one. Cp is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3, where C1, C2, C3 are the capacitances of the three capacitors which are connected in parallel to a battery of potential difference V. Okay, so now let us understand some characteristics of this Cp. First of all, beta, the equivalent capacitance is equal to the sum of the individual. If we generalize it, we will take the n combination of n capacitors, then our formula will become Cp is equal to C1 plus C2 plus up to Cn. Now we can see that the equivalent capacitance is equal to the sum of the individual capacitances, right? The equivalent capacitance is larger. The equivalent capacitance is larger than the largest individual capacitance. The potential difference across each capacitor is same. The potential difference across each capacitor is same. The charge on each capacitor is proportional to its capacitance. From this formula, you can see the charge is directly proportional to the capacitance of the circuit, right? So here V will be constant. We are having different capacitances, so the charges on each capacitor will be different, but on whole if we talk, then we see that charge is directly proportional to the capacitance of the circuit, which means if capacitance is more, that means more charge can be accumulated on this conductor, and if this your capacitance is less, that means that capacitor is having less ability to store the charges, so less charges will be stored on it. So these are very important characteristics which you have to keep. This one is always keep this in your mind. In Cp, in parallel combination, the equivalent capacitance is larger than the largest individual capacitance, and for series combination, the equivalent capacitance is smallest than the smallest of the individual capacitors. Now we come to numericals. So the first numerical says each of the, and there is a circuit which you can see here. Each of uncharged capacitors has a capacitance of 25 microfarad. What charge will flow through the meter M when the switch S is closed? So it is saying that there are these uncharged capacitors having same capacitance. all the capacitors are having capacitance C, which is 25 into, so C is equal to 25 into 10 raised to power minus 6 farad. Right, this is given to us. Now they are saying what charge will flow through this meter when the switch is closed. When this switch is closed, what charge will flow? So if we see, we know that the combination which we are seeing, the plates of the capacitors, all the the one side plates of the capacitor are connected to one terminal of the battery, and the other sides of the plates are connected to the second common terminal of the battery. So this is a parallel combination. So first of all, we have to find out charge. What is given to us? Potential difference is given to us. So the formula which we are going to use is Q is equal to CV. For this, we have to find this C. So let us find out the C for the circuit as they are connected in parallel. So the formula will be CP is equal to 3C, which is 75 microfarad. And V is given to us, which is 4200 volt. So charge is equal to CP into V. So 75 into 10 raised to power minus 6 into 4200. So it comes out to be 315 millicoulomb. So this is the charge. You have to identify the combination. That is very important. Now the second question, calculate the charge supplied by the battery in the arrangement as shown. This is the arrangement which is shown to you. Okay, so we have to calculate the charge. So to calculate the charge, volt is given to us. Potential difference is with us. So the formula which we are going to use is Q is equal to C into V. But we have to find out the C. What is this? Which combination is this? We have to find out first. So yes, we will see that how are they connected. So when you see the circuit, you can see the first plate of capacitor C1 is connected to the positive terminal of our battery, and the first plate, the positive plate of capacitor C2, is also connected to the positive terminal of the battery. That means they are having a common terminal. Then the negative plate of first capacitor is connected to negative terminal of the battery, and negative plate of second capacitor is also connected to the negative terminal of the battery. So this means that these two capacitors are connected in parallel. So we will simplify the circuit now. And when we simplify it, it will be like this. You can see the positive plates of both the capacitors are connected to the positive terminal of the battery, and the negative plates of both the capacitors are connected to the negative terminal of the battery. Now you can simply apply the formula of parallel combination. So C will be equal to C1 plus C2. From here we get 11 microfarad, and we will use the formula for charge, which is Q is equal to C into V. We have got V, which is 10. And we have also got C, which is 11 microfarad. So putting the values, we get 110 microcoulomb. So in this way, you have to identify the combinations, which is very important. Now, the last question. Connect three capacitors of 3 microfarad, 3 microfarad and 6 microfarad such that their equivalent capacitance is 5 microfarad. Now, you cannot say directly that it will be series combination. No. Why? Because it is saying 5 microfarad, and for series combination, you have studied that the capacitance of the equivalent capacitance of the circuit should be smallest than the smallest capacitance. So the smaller than the smallest capacitance means smallest capacitance in this case is 3 microfarad. So the equivalent capacitance should be less than 3 microfarad, whereas it is saying equivalent capacitance is 5 microfarad. So we cannot say ki series combination is it. It is not series combination. Now, pure series combination nahi hai. Theek hai? Uske baad we will see that is it a parallel combination. So for parallel combination, the condition is that the equivalent capacitance should be larger than the largest capacitance. So the largest capacitance is 6 microfarad, whereas the equivalent capacitance is 5 microfarad. That means it is not a pure parallel combination either. So it is neither a series combination or a parallel combination. That means it is combination of both series and parallel. Now we have to see which we are going to combine in parallel and what we are going to combine in series. So first of all, we will find out the maximum value and minimum value. For maximum, that means we are doing parallel combination. So for parallel, the C max will be 12 microfarad. And if they are connected in series, so minimum will be 1.2 microfarad. So our capacitance is in between. So that means we have to find out the combination. So now to find out the combination, 5 microfarad ko agar hum split kare, so we get 3 plus 2. Because we already have 3, so we will divide it into 3 plus 2. Right? We cannot do 6 minus 1. No. We will do 3 plus 2. That means 1 for sure is connected in series. Ye 3 microfarad is connected in series. Now 2, how do we get 2? If we combine the other two capacitors in parallel, which two are left? That is 3 microfarad and 6 microfarad. So we will combine these two in parallel. So we get the answer. So we should combine the series combination of 3 microfarad and 6 microfarad capacitors in parallel with the third capacitor of 3 microfarad. So what does it signify? It signifies this diagram will be like this. 3 microfarad, then 6. So it will be connected like 6. So this is what is asked to you. Connect 3 capacitors of 3 microfarad, 3 microfarad and 6 microfarad such that their equivalent capacitance is 5 microfarad. So you will combine it like this. Now, just a second, beta. Now the last question. After this, we will start with energy stored in the circuit. So the question is, 4 capacitors are connected as shown in figure. Calculate the equivalent capacitance between the two points X and Y. This is very important. This type of question is very important. And earlier which we did this one. This is also very important. And then these kind of questions. So all the examples which we have done, they are important. Such kind of questions come in the exams as well. So here we can see there are 4 capacitors connected like this. Now we have to find out the capacitance, equivalent capacitance across X and Y. X and Y ke beech mein hamari kitni capacitance banegi. So first of all, we have to identify the circuit. To identify the circuit, we will see what is the combination going on. Just a second. Let me finish this question, then I'll take up your doubts. So here you can see there are two terminals before X and Y. They are A and B. So we have to find out that what is the relation of these terminals to the plates of the capacitors. So you can see that the first terminal, the first plate of capacitor is connected to A, and the first plate of this capacitor is also connected to A, and this plate is also, the second capacitor's plate is also connected to A. So that means they are having same common terminal. Similarly, if we see B, so the second plate of first capacitor is connected to it, then this capacitor's plate is also connected to it, and the third capacitor's plate is connected to it. So that means they are having common the two plates. We have two plates of this capacitors. So the first three plates are connected to one terminal, that is A, and the other three plates are connected to the second terminal, that is B. So it means this is a parallel combination. So they are in parallel combination to each other, and in turn they are connected in series with the fourth capacitor. So now it is very easy to solve. First of all, you have to simplify the circuit for you. Then you will see which combination is there, and then you will solve it. So for parallel, it will be 2 plus 3 plus 5, which is 10 microfarad. Now they are in series with each other. So 10 plus 10 you can't do. You will apply 1 by Cs is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So it is 5 microfarad. So now the question is that calculate the equivalent capacitance, and you have calculated it is 5 microfarad. So in this way you will solve the questions for your capacitances when they are connected in different combinations of series and parallel.